Hey YouTube! Thank you for stopping by my channel, The Magical Solution. My name is Leilani. If you are new to my channel, welcome. If you are a loyal subscriber, thank you guys so much for sticking with me and I hope you continue to do so. So today's topic is actually a video response to a very wonderful young pagan girl on YouTube. Her name is KittyMoon and her YouTube channel is My Pagan Life, and if you haven't already checked it out, please do so. If you are into the pagan Wiccan kind of community, her channel is a great place to start. Her videos are concise, intelligent, she's got pictures, music, all kinds of fun stuff for you guys. So I'll leave a link down below so you can check it out, okay? But she posed a question last week that I think is a really, really great question for any practitioner, not just people who are pagan or Wiccan. And her question, her idea was, you know, how do you get yourself motivated? How do you inspire yourself to do spiritual stuff, right? And I think that that is such an important question, because whether you're new to the magical community or you're an experienced elder in the magical community, either way, we all go through those moments of just spiritual downtime, I guess, and this sometimes doubt, sometimes fear, sometimes you know, just feeling like, oh, well, I did all the magical stuff I can do for this week and I'm feeling a little, I need more stuff, what do I do? You know, you have that too. So either way, I think this question really helps any practitioner. It's like, how do you get yourself in that mode, right? How do you make yourself feeling all witchy and spiritual? So, Miss KittyMoon, I have a bunch of suggestions because I go through that all the time, especially when I was first starting out, all the time. So, but before I begin, let me just kind of do the formality part of it, because, you know, I've posed this question to other practitioners, especially older ones, and pretty much all of them had the same like four things that they told me. And I think they're good things just to say to any newcomer and anyone who's coming into this community fresh and just doesn't know what to do. The first thing that was said to me was, if you are coming into this community, make sure it's something you really want to do, right? Because what I was told it from these individuals was, these spiritual lulls, they'll start to decrease when you've gotten more of an investment in it. So, oh, excuse me, just had some coffee. So when you come into the community and you're kind of approaching it kind of like as a hobby or just something that you do here and there, you're not as committed to it. And so your faith in it and your ability to come in and out and feeling these ups and downs with it is more likely to happen. So, you know, our advice to you is make a commitment to yourself. Make a commitment to your path, to your tradition, to your spirits, whatever you do. And one of the ways to do it is to actually write out like a little mini contract that you hold yourself accountable to, right? So write yourself something, dedicate it to whatever tradition or whatever spirits you're working with, sign it, you know, close it up and put it in a safe place, somewhere on your altar, maybe in a cute little box or someplace. And when you're feeling down, take it out and read that contract to yourself and remember what you committed to and why you're doing what you're doing. Super important. Another thing that they had mentioned was this idea of finding spirit and divinity and beauty in everything you do. There won't be a spiritual lull if everything you do is spiritual. Now, that doesn't mean that you walk around out there in the real world, you know, with your head wrap on with like tons of jewelry and like you're walking your giant walking stick with a huge crystal on top and like, you know, just spraying incense at people. Like they're not, they don't mean that. Just if you are going for a drive, right? Making that drive a spiritual drive and allowing that communion to happen. If you're going for a walk, make it a spiritual walk. If you're going to the grocery store, even if everything that you're buying is for your weekly mundane, like breakfast, lunch, and dinners, buy that one thing, just that one thing for your spiritual stuff so that it keeps it in the mix, right? So finding spirit in everything. That was the second thing that they told me. And then the third thing that they told me was getting a routine. This is super, super important. And whether it's 5 minutes a day or 15 minutes a day or an hour a day, making sure that you do that every single time and you hold yourself accountable for it. And writing yourself that contract that you read will help you to do that. All right, so those were the three things that I kind of was told, and I feel like it's good information. I mean, it's coming from people who've been here for a long time, who've been doing this for a long time, and who totally understand this idea of kind of, you know, having downtime. So those are the philosophical things you want to hold in the back of your mind. Now let's get to the fun stuff, because, you know, I did the formalities already. As far as the fun stuff goes, oh, don't forget to visit my other videos. And the reason why I say that is my other videos kind of break down how to strengthen your will through each element. And when you're doing that, you're strengthening your connection to those elements, your communion with those elements, and you're strengthening your own power so that you can approach your spirituality with even more motivation and more inspiration. So I really highly suggest you check out my other videos. Now to the fun stuff. Okay, so what did I do to get myself spiritually motivated during those times when I was feeling down? Well, one of the things that I loved, loved, loved to do when I was younger was go for walks, right? I used to live in a neighborhood where the park was about a mile and a half away, just enough distance where the walk was just beautiful. It was perfect, you know, it was a perfect distance. And I, in order to make it spiritual and in order to make it more inspiring, I gave myself a theme every time I went for a walk. It made it different. So I would go for a walk and, for example, try and find all of the elements out in nature. Now, obviously, Earth is an easy one to find because you're on planet Earth, so you can see the trees and you can see the rocks and you can see everything. So obviously, Earth is the easiest one, but some of the other elements are kind of difficult to find when you're going out on a walk, especially when you're taking like one specific route. And especially when your natural environment isn't conducive to any one particular element. So what I mean by that is, like, let's say you live in like Arizona or something, or someplace that's really, really dry and deserty. Finding water on your path, the element of water on your path, can be kind of difficult. So it's a challenge. It gets your creative juices flowing. It allows you to seek those elements, and it allows those elements to then seek you. So that's a fun one. Another one that I liked to do was going out and looking for omens. Yes, so here's the thing with that though. When you're out there and you're trying to look for signs, right? You don't really want to look for them, but at the same time, you want to keep your senses open and ready to receive any messages that might be sent to you. So here's my advice with the omen walk. Before you leave your front door, just say a quick, like, 30-second prayer to whatever spirit you believe in or whatever universal energy you believe in, right? And just tell that energy, I am going for a walk specifically to receive messages from you. So if you got something to say, now's the time to say it, because I'm going to go out that door and I'm going to be waiting and listening and ready for these messages. Now, the first couple times you do it, you might not get anything. Totally cool. But keep trying, because after a while, it's going to get, the universe will condition, it gets conditioned and will work its way into sending you those messages, especially things that you might need to hear. So that one's a fun one. When it gets going, it's really fun. Another walk that I used to do, and this one is really fun for me because I'm kind of a hoarder a little bit. No, I can't say that because that's like an actual disease. But anyway, I love to collect things. So I would go on walks to collect things for my spiritual work. So, you know, finding cool looking rocks, finding cool sticks that you can carve into a wand, finding feathers, just anything, you know. And once again, you know, before you leave your house, tell the universe, like, look, I'm gonna go out and collect stuff for my spiritual altar and for my craftings, you know, make sure that the right things fall in my path for me to get. And you'll be surprised what you'll find. It's really, really fun. A lot of fun. Another walk that I love to do, but this one I encourage you to do inside your home, not out in the community, okay? This is called the blindfold walk, and it's exactly what it sounds like, blindfolding yourself. Here's the thing though. If you're living with family members or roommates or something like that, get them in on it. It's actually really helpful for you, and here's why I say that. If, let's say, you know, you're blindfolded and you're just, you know, going through your whole house or whatever, and you touch something that you're not quite sure what it is, take that moment and try and guess, you know, feel it all up and, you know, just really sense it with all your other senses and try and guess what it is. Where your roommates and where your family members can help is you can call someone over and say, hey, listen, I feel an unidentified object and I think it's this. Am I right? And allow them to either confirm it or deny it for you. And that's really, really important, because the minute you take off that blindfold to check to see what that is, your brain, the way your brain works is that it automatically takes note of everything around you and will reset itself. So now, whether you perceived it at that moment or not is not the point. You, in the back of your mind, you know what's around you now, and it takes away the mystery. And the mystery is what you want, because you want to strengthen your senses and allow them to bloom and blossom, right? And this can be a really, really fun activity and very engaging with your housemates. They'll love it. They'll look at you like you're a crazy person just walking around, and they'll laugh at you when you bump into things, and it could be a really, really fun activity. So have fun with that one. Let's see what else. I had to write everything down because I went through these moments a lot. I really did when I was first starting out. Let's see. Oh, shopping, right? So going out there, and when you're buying clothes for yourself, just buying one article of clothing that is just for your spiritual stuff. So whether it be a new scarf or a new dress or maybe a bracelet or a necklace, whatever, just that one thing in addition to your regular shopping stuff, I think is a very spiritual process. You know, you're taking your time with it. You're looking for the right symbols, the right beads, the right this, the right that. Make it a beautiful day, right? Another thing that is, I would think, is very obvious is gardening. Oh my God. First of all, you're connecting with nature. It's super spiritual. You're helping stuff grow. Then you're using those things in your magic, the herbs, the flowers, whatever it is you are growing. I mean, it just hits spiritual stuff on so many levels. It's crazy. So garden. And if you don't have a garden, get potted plants. It's that easy, you know? I don't think I even have to say anything more than that. But what you can do, let me just ask. How many of you have, as a kid, made mud pies? I loved making mud pies. I didn't eat them. I wasn't the kid who, like, went that far and just shoved it in his, no. But I did make mud pies, and I enjoyed doing that. As an adult, though, and as an older teen, take it a step further. Go outside, get your dirt, put the water in it, make your mud pie, right? A little mud patty. But this time, take your wand or your athame or your finger, and this time I want you to carve your favorite magical symbols, your sigils, your vivis, your geometric, you know, symbols. Just put whatever you want on there that's spiritual to you, that will invoke that feeling of spirituality. And then go and put those mud pies in your garden, or go and put them in your potted plants. They're good for the plant, and you're also imbuing it with magic and a spell even. You can even put a whole petition or a whole written out thing on that mud pie. And if, I don't know if you live with your parents or if you're on your own, but you can even bake it and harden it up and then put it, you know, in your garden. Whatever you want to do. It's really cool though. Let's see. When I was young, I used to do this a lot, and you can totally ask my mom about this because she'll laugh all day. I used to make potions, but like with all of her beauty products. So like I would steal like her lotions, her perfumes, her makeup stuff, anything that was just around, I would take it and I would go to my room and I would mix things together and I don't know how she put up with me, I swear. I'm thinking about it now. I'm like, oh my gosh, she must have wanted to rip my hair out. But anyway, so as a kid, you know, you did a lot of potion making. It was fun and it was joyful and it made you feel extremely magical. Potion making, dude. This time you can go to the store, go to the pharmacy, even grocery stores, and get yourself those really cheap essential oils that I don't suggest that you ingest nor put on your skin, but you can get them for potion making and having a fun time with that. Different kinds of lotions, different kind of food colorings, whatever you want, and just have a good old time mixing stuff together. It may not have any magical use whatsoever, and it may. But the point is that it instigates those creative fun juices to flow. It makes you feel like a kid again and joyful, and it brings back a little magic into your life. Go for it. And I think the very last one I have on my list, and probably one of the most important ones, is community. Community. Go to those open circles if you have them in your area. Go to those meetup groups if you have them in your area. And you know what? If you don't have them in your area, start one. Start one and post it on all of those sites and just allow people to come and conversate with you. Join a book club, a magical book club where you guys just read magical books and talk about it. The whole point of this is surround yourself with like-minded people. This is how you grow. This is how you learn from each other. This is how you stay motivated. As a teacher, I always tell my students, you are who you hang with. So if you're hanging out with, you know, kids who are making bad choices, engaging in criminal activity and bad sexual choices, then you're gonna fall into those trappings. But if you hang out with those kids who are doing good on their tests and want to go to college and are making the right choices, you're gonna fall into those trappings. So it's ultimately up to you. At the end of the day, just surround yourself with people who are gonna help you grow, not hold you back, right? I think that's the most important piece of this whole thing. But at the end of the day, every day is a spiritual day. Every activity is a spiritual activity. Just remember that. Keep it in all of your work. Give yourself a routine, and I promise these lulls will start to disappear one at a time. These moments of fear, this moment of doubt, this moment of boredom with your spirituality, it'll all start to just fade away. All right, and have fun with it. So, Kitty Moon from My Pagan Life, thank you so much for this question and for really bringing up a subject that a lot of people struggle with. I think it was an absolutely great topic. Yeah, and I will see you guys soon. Stick around, like, comment, subscribe. Let me know in your comments, in the comments below, how you deal with getting yourself inspired and motivated. I would love, love, love to hear it all. All right? And don't forget to share. Bye.